Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to do keyword research so you pick up the right keywords for your website, videos or blog posts. Hello, I'm Uzair and thanks for joining in. This video is all about keyword research. What you need to do to find the right keywords for your website, videos or blog post. So let's get started. So before you start researching, there are two types of keywords which you need to know. One is what we call a short tail. And these are usually between one to two words. And the other one is long tail. And these are anything from three plus words, and these are the keywords which you want to target, the long tail one, because the short tail ones are too competitive. Although they may have a lot of search volume, if your website is not in any kind of authority or you don't you're just starting out at the moment, so what you want to do is to go after the long tail keywords. They are very, very easy to rank, and you start to generate traffic very quickly. So I would always recommend that you start with a long tail keyword. The other couple of things which you need to know is the level of competition. And the number of searches, and that's what you want to find keywords for, where you have got a very low level of competition and the number of searches is enough to give you a decent amount of traffic to your website. So what it would be a decent number of searches? I would say anything between 300 plus per month on Google. So you can start to get a percentage of those visitors to your traffic. We are not going after the big keywords where you have got thousands and thousands of searches, because it will be very, very difficult to rank for that keyword. So to give you an analogy as to how to pick up a keyword, imagine if you had two boxing rings in front of you and you need to step in one of them to fight. The first one has got a heavyweight boxer and the other one has got a very lightweight amateur boxer. Which one would you rather fight? Obviously the amateur one and the lightweight one every time, isn't it? Because with a bit of training and exercising, you stand a chance to beat this fella. He's going to throw some punches at you. You're going to throw some punches at him. And you stand a 50% chance of winning that match. Whereas with this heavyweight guy, we stand no chance. Because no matter how much training, exercising we do, there is no way in the world we'll be able to beat that heavyweight boxer, because some keywords are like these. You don't want to pick up a fight with this one. You want to pick up a fight every time with a keyword which is like this lightweight boxer, so at least you have got a chance to win. And when someone picks up the wrong keyword, that's where the frustration kicks in, because you do all the hard work, you put up blog posts, videos, you do all the right things, but you still can't get any rankings or traffic to your website. And that is why you can't. It's because you picked up the wrong keyword. So if you were to start going to the gym to get fit or get lose weight and build up muscles, it's not going to happen within a few weeks. You have to regularly go to the gym, train, exercise, and obviously have the right diet. And then you're going to build up the stamina, the muscles, the strength. And that's how your website also builds up the strength to beat your competitors. And it doesn't happen overnight. It happens over a period of time. So keep picking up the low-hanging fruit, the long-tail keywords, which has got a very weak competition, but a fair amount of searches. And you start to get traffic, and you will start to see that things are working. So how do you find those keywords? So let me show you an example of how I'm ranking for keywords for my videos. So as you can see, I'm in my dashboard over here for this video, and most of my tags are getting ranked now. When I go to YouTube and put in that search, this video is now coming up on number 2 just within a week. So it does work, and it happens very, very quickly if you pick up the right keywords, because Google AdWords, this niche is very competitive as well. So I need to pick up all the low-hanging fruits or the weaker keywords, which has got not a huge amount of traffic, but slowly but sure and surely I'm going to start getting rankings, start getting to get traffic, and build up my channel strength. Okay, so the tool which I recommend to find long tail keywords is called ubersuggest. ubersuggest.io. It's a great tool, and it's going to give you a ton of keywords. So if I were to go in there and put in Google AdWords tutorial. Now in here, you've got an option for web, images, shopping, YouTube, or news. I'm going to choose web. You can also select the country. I'm going to keep it US because that's where the most traffic is. Click suggest. And now I have got loads of keywords. Now the way these are sorted out are by alphabetical order. So you can see Google AdWords, API, Advanced API, and so on. Then what you do is you take ideas from here, all these long tail keywords which are relevant for you, take them into the Google Keyword Planner and see the amount of traffic you have in there. The other thing which you can also see over here is the monthly volume over here as well. So I double check whether this is correct or not, and usually it is pretty close. You can also get the CPC suggested bid and the amount of competition over here as well. So you can either view them as a text, copy and paste it and put them on your desktop, or you can download them all as a in a spreadsheet as a CSV file and open them up in a spreadsheet. And this is how I do my keyword research before I create any content, especially my blog posts and my videos. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I would love to hear which tools you use for your keyword research. And if you would like to be notified when I upload similar videos like this one, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button. Thanks for joining me. I really appreciate your time, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.